feel like your time on in the camera light is limited, okay?
If I was to say who gonna be acting up, I think she gonna turn up. She just seemed like if he say something to her wrong, she might punch that nigga off shit. She put
I want y'all to know right now while y'all watching this. However these niggas act on this goddamn podcast ain't got nothing to do with me. I am a very respectful male. But this is crazy.
This how you talk to girls?
Hell no, I'm baffled, to be honest.
I'm like, actually appalled.
Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I was like, damn. I don't know if I got that enemy to like.
They just listening too. Ladies, listen, y'all. Let me tell y'all something real quick. Don't let no man talk to y'all like this, okay? This ain't right. I don't give a fuck what they trying to tell y'all in the world. This ain't right. Everybody's regular human. I think men and women should be treated equally. Yeah. Everybody come on here try to be cool and try to be disrespectful to girls.
Yeah.
But ain't nothing cool about being disrespectful to a girl. So really,
change the outlook on that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. My purpose for being here today is to show the world that all women should be treated like queens,
yeah,
and they should be treated with respect.
Dignity.
Not like they just
not like piece of meat.
Piece of meat that's just supposed to cook and clean and do this.
Yeah.
Come on now. We gonna change the narrative today. Business niggas two-faced. Dickmatizing women when I hit it, feel like Blueface. Yeah. I ain't trying to fuck, just give me head. I turn on my reading seats and I leave bad bitches on red. I don't get no fuck.
Outlook on that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. My purpose for being here today is to show the world that all women should be treated like queens.
Yeah.
And they should be treated with respect.
Dignity.
Not like they
not
just
like piece of meat.
Piece of meat that's just supposed to cook and clean and do this.
Yeah.
Come on now. We gonna change the narrative today. For y'all do 200 a month, and what? Got your main bitch
trying to sign my stuff, and what? I might sign her ass and turn her up, then drop her and fuck. Outlook on that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. My purpose for being here today is to show the world that all women should be treated like queens.
Yeah.
And they should be treated with respect.
Dignity.
Not like they
not like piece of meat.
Piece of meat still.
I'm finna go buy a Birkin. Spoiling women and taking them shopping. I'm tripping. I cut off a bitch and return it. Outlook on that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. My purpose for being here today is to show the world that all women should be treated like queens.
Yeah.
And they should be treated with respect.
Dignity.
Not like they
not
just.
Not like piece of meat.
Piece of meat still.
Quick 10 to 100 bands. Bring the proceeds to the function.
Yes. However these niggas act on this goddamn podcast, they got nothing to do with me. I am a very respectful male.
Ladies and gentlemen, we give these artists and these influencers a pass so many times about so many different things and contradictory statements they might make or hypocritical things they might do. But I think it's about time we start calling them out, right? And I'm not going to edit that out because I stutter sometimes. Well, let's get into it. DDG, if you're looking for the definition of a simp or panda bear, this video accurately explains that. Not only does the show highlight the BS, also highlights how these supportive, treat all women the same, XYZ, how they're, you know, hypocritical at the same time. What's the word I'm looking for? At the same time, exposing opportunistic nature, capitalizing off of the pain of others. It's a reach, but you'll see what I'm saying when I break it down for you. So let's roll the clip.
Pretty good. Yeah. We're still cheaper than New York City and LA, you know? And the weather's better, hotter girls. You know what I mean? Like LA, like y'all got hot girls, but like, you gotta go looking for it and shit. Here, there's bad bitches everywhere. And another thing too, when you have an abundance of hot girls, but just gotta act right, bro. They like, hey, you can't give me an attitude when there's a hotter chick than you, right?
That's
right,
why you're gonna get cancer, bro.
Hey, yeah, hey, Tyler, probably.
You ain't gonna get my shit yellow.
Damn, I mean, they're gonna have to put that on the OnlyFans.
One more time. With me, I am a very respectful male. However.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. One more time, ladies. 1 more time. 1, 2.
I want y'all to know right now while y'all watching this. However. However these niggas act on this goddamn podcast ain't got nothing to do with me. I am a very respectful male. But this is crazy.
This how you talk to girls?
Yeah, no, I'm baffled, to be honest.
I'm like, actually appalled.
Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I was like, damn. I don't know if I got that in me to like.
They just listening too. Ladies, listen, y'all. Let me tell y'all something real quick. Don't let no man talk to y'all like this, okay? This ain't right. I don't give a fuck what they trying to tell y'all in the world. This ain't right. Everybody's regular human. I think men and women should be treated equally. Yeah. Everybody come on here try to be cool and try to be disrespectful to girls.
Yeah.
But ain't nothing cool about being disrespectful to a girl. So really,
change the outlook on that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. My purpose for being here today is to show the world that all women should be treated like queens,
yeah,
and they should be treated with respect.
Dignity.
Not like they just
not like piece of meat.
Piece of meat that's just supposed to cook and clean and do this.
Yeah.
Come on now. We gonna change the narrative today. I don't know about Rich.
What you mean? You don't know about me, nigga? I'm on the same page.
Yeah, but I'm gonna change the narrative today, man. It should be fun, though. It should be cool. First one was good. It's your time, bro.
Come on.
I ain't gonna lie, bro. You gotta get clipped. You might have the wig on one of the girls and shit.
I think the ghost fucked my husband.
I'm sorry, what?
Let me be the positive nigga.
No.
Because I wouldn't, you gotta get clipped, bro. It's time.
That's the only way.
Time to get your face out there, man.
No, for sure.
You gotta get clipped.
Like, bro, the first part was cool. That was like a little teaser. Now it's like, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? This not me, y'all, but I'm just telling Rick. Bitch, what the fuck wrong with you? You know what I'm saying? One of those type shit. Type shit.
Bro.
Get clipped and shit. We're gonna do it right, man. We're gonna make sure it's entertaining. I don't wanna be lame at the same time, but.
Yeah, I was thinking too. I don't wanna be a lame episode where it's like it's boring, but I don't wanna be on no, this nigga doing too much. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I need you to do a lot. Do too much, bro.
Do too much?
Do too much. I don't even wanna talk for real.
I bet.
This ain't even my. I shouldn't even be.
Yeah,
doing.
No, for sure.
Let like me tell y'all this.
Gonna
I'm doing
it.
This.
We're gonna toss it.
Because I already know. I'm doing this for marketing reasons for this man, okay? I love FreshnFit though, but
for sure.
I fuck with the first part, but the after hours shit, I'm doing this for you, bro.
Nah, for sure, real nigga.
So just get clipped, man, please.
Gotcha.
So we can sell some records.
So one, what makes this clip so bad is he's literally at these boys' penthouse. He's at the FreshnFit podcast. He's at their penthouse, right? As he's making that statement, right? One, why didn't he speak up if they were the way he said it, or where they set that little scene up right there, made it seem like FreshnFit they were insulting women or treating women badly or speaking to them negatively at that very moment, because they did the first half of the interview where, no disrespect to Fresh, he was genuinely sucking DDG's dick. I keep it 1,000. Right, so they're showing this man love and appreciation, shouting out his career, his music, XYZ. Then, at the midpoint, he says this nonsense, right? They haven't talked to the woman yet. At the moment, they're setting up to get the after hours part of the podcast started, and he's making those comments. So if you were, as his friend said, I was so appalled at how they were speaking to the woman, why didn't you say something right then and there when they were so supposedly speaking to women bad? Why don't you stop them right there if you truly believe what you were saying, or what you were implied were saying was actually happening? Why didn't you step into that role and say something then, right? That's number one. So then you make that little statement on your little videos for your supporters. Oh, I think all women should be treated equal. I think all women are queens. So again, you didn't say nothing then. Right, then y'all said y'all was gonna change. I'm gonna post the clips from the podcast, right? What happened right there is what we saw, he said, I don't even want to. He basically said he doesn't want to be there, that he was only doing this for marketing to help boost the song, right? So already in his mind, he has some negative connotation to the after hours part of the show, even though for those who have watched the show, you know, Fresh and Myron, they don't bash women. They don't speak to women negatively. In fact, you would say that Fresh and Myron are being feminist because they speak to women on an equal footing. They're not sugarcoating anything. You're equal. You're a grown adult like me. I'm going to talk to you and lay out the truth. Strict like that. There's no woman bashing that goes on during the after hours part of the podcast. Of course, they have their jokes inside, ha ha, he he, that might not be for the standard public consumption or, you know, people who are too sensitive. Sure. Right, but at the end of the day, that's not the after hours part of the podcast. It's not about disrespecting women or talking to women negatively. And then not only that, you also badmouth all the other guests on the show that came previously by you saying everybody gets on there and wants to act cool, think it's cool to talk bad about women. That's not cool. People don't get on there to do that. That's the funny thing, right? Then, and I'm going to drop some clips in here so you guys can see the After Hours podcast, or you could go spend the three hours watching it yourself, right? However, what was funny is they said they're going to change the narrative today, right? And as that, what we saw was a regular After Hours podcast, right? There wasn't too much pushback from the guests, right? And the women were, for the most part, pretty much on board and agreeing and actually speaking truth from a woman's perspective on what women want and agreeing at the end of the day with Myron and Fresh, right? So his narrative of we're going to change the narrative today, that never happened, right? Again, you can go watch it. I'll drop some clips in there. In fact, there were times when the woman said stuff and you see DDG seem like, oh, shit. Damn. Right? You can go watch and watch it yourself, right? So this narrative, that in itself was a treachery in my eyes. You backstab these people for your content and say one thing, but when you were there, you didn't give that same energy. What was funny about you saying that is you have plenty of opportunity during the set to supposedly change those views or speak up for women or XYZ, whatever bullshit narrative you're trying to push right there. But you didn't. There were so many times the microphone's put on you for you to say something, and you didn't really say nothing, right? Except the one time when you said, when they asked you, what do you look for a woman? You said, well, I'm independent, so I look for a woman that's independent, who got her own thing going on. And they let you slide, right? And I believe they let you slide simply because Myron's voice was out of there.
What else? Looks, obviously. And, really, independency.
Mm.
Yeah, I like girls that got their own shit going.
Mm. So they don't bother you all the time?
Not even that. And it's just like, you know, the way I work, like, I'm independent. So it's like, it's attractive to me when a girl is independent, you know?
Okay. All right. Yeah. Peace of mind.
All right. Cool. Chats?
Yeah.
And Fresh was just so happy that you're there, whatever, right? But they would have pushed back on that normally. We're like, what do you mean? What does that mean? Explain that, right? Even Destiny, blue hair Destiny, who came on there, had a lot more spine to talk back to Myron and Fresh based on his beliefs. And even when the women were disagreeing with Destiny at some points in time, he still stood his ground. You didn't say nothing about what you was talking about. But then you post that video right before the After Hours podcast began. You post that how y'all were going to XYZ do XYZ such and such and stick up for women. But when the time came, you didn't do nothing. Why? Because the After Hours podcast is not about bashing women. It's showing men what women really want for the most part and how to adjust to that. So, and then let's... And this is a whole 6-minute intro because we're going to start dropping clips here in a second. I'm not even going to edit or cut it out. But then the last part of this, which is what I'm going to explain how. In fact, let's put that part of the clip up again.
It's your time, bro.
Come on.
I ain't going to lie, bro. You got to get clipped. You might have the wig on one of the girls and shit.
I think the ghost fucked my husband.
I'm sorry, what?
Let me be the positive nigga.
No,
because I wasn't
I would. You gotta get clipped, bro. It's time.
That's the only way.
Time to get your face out there, man.
No, for sure.
You gotta get clipped.
Like, bro, the first part was cool. That was like a little teaser. Now it's like, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? This not me, y'all. But I'm just telling Rick. Bitch, the fuck wrong with you? You know what I'm saying? One of those type shit. Type shit.
Bro.
Get clipped and shit. We're gonna do it right, man. We're gonna make sure it's a entertaining. I don't wanna be lame at the same time, but.
Yeah, I don't want to. That's what I was thinking too. I don't want it to be a lame episode where it's like it's boring, but I don't want to be on no. Oh, this nigga doing too much. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I need you to do a lot. Do too much, bro.
Do too much.
Do too much. I don't even want to talk for real.
I bet.
This ain't even my. I shouldn't even be.
Yeah,
doing.
No, for sure.
Let me tell y'all this. I'm doing this.
We're gonna toss it.
Because I already know. I'm doing this for marketing reasons for this man. Okay, I love FreshnFit though, but
for sure.
The after, I fuck with the first part, but the after hours shit, I'm doing this for you, bro.
Nah, for sure, real nigga.
So just get clipped, man, please.
Gotcha.
So we can sell some records.
So you see, he says, "Oh, they wanna sell, market this song or this album that they got coming up," and he's telling his partner, his buddy, "You need to get clipped." And he says to the camera, "Oh, this is not me, but bitch, da 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 da." So basically, after just saying people come on here and think it's cool to disrespect women, but we're going to change the narrative to ending this part of this section where we need to sell this song. So go on there and disrespect women. You got to get clipped. You got to go viral. This is your king? That's who you believe in? So you're telling me I believe in women. All women should be treated like queens, but hey, we got to sell this song, bro, so you need to be disrespectful to women and, you know, say some crazy shit to women so you get viral and people look at you so we can make money on this song. So you want to profit off the disrespect of women, but you support women, right? And that's what I say, pandering, simps, Derek Jackson type niggas who would say one thing to profit off the love and kindness and appreciation of black women or women in general, and then really be doing another thing to either make money, i.e. the hyper-sexualization of women in music, in songs. Oh, he's a rapper. I'm pretty sure you could pull up one of his songs right now where he's treating women like a piece of meat, right? So let's stop playing. Come on now. We got to hold people accountable for what they're talking about. And then you did it on their, you did it behind their backs on their podcast right after they're hyping you up and saying all good positive things about you. And then you go over here and drop this on your side. Oh, like you didn't say nothing when you was there. You didn't say nothing while he was on the show. Like, come on. And then I'm going to drop this clip too. He goes, "Oh, yeah, what I look for a woman is really a sense of humor." And then I love that the black queen a couple seats over, she immediately checked you. She said, "Oh, so a woman just gonna laugh you at your drawers?"
I'm big on personality and humor.
Mm.
Humor is like damn near neck and neck with looks, for real.
Mm.
Damn, so like, a bitch can laugh you out your drawers.
Everybody laughed because haha, it's funny, but really? Really? So you with your girl right now because she had a great sense of humor? Or what really attracted you first because she looked good? Like, stop playing. Right? That attracted you. Like, if we're talking about sense of humor, I know Lizzo's funny. I know Lizzo could cook for show. So why you not with Lizzo? Lizzo cute. Oh, Lizzo's independent, right? She got her own thing going on, since that's what you like, that's what you look for in a woman, right? And I'm sure, yeah. So be real. Like I said, the only reason I think Myron didn't push on that is just simply because his voice was added after the party that you was on the private jet party, the $1 million, whatever it was, a million party on the yacht. He was there. So you doing all these behind the scenes comments talking about XYZ to try to save your image and profit off of the love of women, but then at the same time you want to also profit on the pain of women. Like, what are you talking about? Like, what are we? But nobody's saying that. Nobody, no, none of your father's gonna check you. Nah, I'ma check you, bruh. That was weak. That was soft. That was some simp shit. Some pander shit. And I see, yo, cool. You got a girl. High profile too. So of course you want to protect that too as well. I understand. But she, like, if you gonna say something, you gotta really be about it. Like, you didn't say nothing on the show. You didn't say nothing on the show. On the actual show, it was live too. So there was no edits, it was live. So what are we talking about? It was live. Like, but you want to say, oh, the vibes was great at the show. I loved it here. You didn't want to be there. You said it. You just wanted to be there to help market the song for him. Like, so you, one right there, that shows you have no respect for their platform or what they have done, or even them appreciating you and seeing you as high value enough to be on the show in the first place, because they love what you're doing. But it's not the same way around. And then while you're still there on their podcast, in their space, you talking shit to the camera. But you, I'm repeating myself. But the chat on Fresh's side, they saw it. They saw it. So we're gonna put it out there for everybody to see. Let the public decide. Is this your king? This is someone you look up to? This is your protector of women right here? The modern man? This is the modern man right here? A man who says, I love all women are queens and shouldn't be talked to any type of way and not treated like a piece of meat. But I want to sell this song, so I need you to treat women like a piece of meat, talk to them crazy, so you can go viral, get attention, so we can make money off of it.
Face out there, man.
No, for sure.
You gotta get clipped.
Like, the first part was cool, and like a little teaser. Now it's like, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? This not me, y'all, but I'm just telling Rick.
Bitch, the fuck wrong with
you? You know what I'm saying? One of those type shit.
Hold on. Baby Rich.
What's good?
DDG, tell me, if you're a shorty, smash a dude down the street, would you want to tell you that you smashed him or no?
Shit.
Be for
keep
real.
It a buck. Keep it a buck.
I don't be honest. Me personally, I like a little slip, bitch. You feel me? I'm going to put it like this, though. You feel me?
Oh, yeah.
Hoes be the coolest people. You feel me?
Oh, sometimes.
I ain't
going to
lie.
Sometimes.
Nah,
hoes
be cool.
Some of them be
I like a little slut. You just got to find me a loyal slut. You feel me? A faithful slut.
Now everybody really thinking they hoeness.
Because me personally, I kind of care, but I don't care. Because once I punch this dick inside this hoe, all the other niggas ain't even going to matter no more. You feel me?
Yeah.
So it ain't even going to, I don't really care what you did. Because once you give me, bitch, it's a whole new experience.
Oh, wow.
You
punching it in there?
Man, I'm
You molly whopping that thing with you?
If your girl, right, is with you,
yeah,
and a nigga she's smashing from before walking past you guys, would you want to know the truth?
No.
What?
100%.
Wouldn't want to know.
What's the point? Because then what? What if she goes fight the nigga for?
Or what if he come up and try to hug you?
Right.
It's like, but it's like it shouldn't even matter.
Don't let this nigga dab me up.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So you might think that was a great answer, but it's not. You can see him moderate his answer depending on how the women are reacting. You see how they're nodding first? Well, first they're questioning him, then he changed it so they began nodding with him. Pay attention.
She go fight the nigga for
what if he come up and try to hug you?
Right.
It's like, but it's like, it shouldn't even matter.
Don't let this nigga dab me up.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
But if that should be her job not to even let me around the nigga. But right. I don't wanna know. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. I do feel like it don't really matter unless somebody still got feelings.
Women understand it and they knew exactly what disrespect is and what shouldn't be happening and what they shouldn't allow.